In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to build your own specialised corpus using the interface english-corpora.org. So in order to do this, you need to make sure that you're logged in to your personal account on english-corpora.org. You cannot upload your own texts, but what you can do is create your own specialised custom subcorpus from any of the corpora available on the interface. On this platform, this is called creating a virtual corpus. And you can save these on your personal account and access them at any other time. So for example, you could create your own subcorpus from the movie corpus to only include film scenes that refer to hospitals or weddings, for example. You could also create a specialized Wikipedia virtual corpus. So for example, if you're interested in skincare, you could create a virtual corpus that only deals with anything to do with skincare that is included in the Wikipedia corpus. To illustrate this, we're actually going to create our own corpus based on the Now corpus news on the web. So that's what we'll click on for now. This takes us to the Now corpus search interface. And if we click here on Text Virtual, we have the option to create a corpus. So here we're creating what's referred to here as a virtual corpus. So it's our own personalized corpus within Now. Let's click on Create Corpus. And here you have various options. You can either select a web domain. So for example, we could pick only the articles from the Times. We can select individual words from article titles. So if I were to type here Obama, we would obtain all of the articles that have Obama in the title. We could select or deselect specific countries of origin from the text. So we could say we're only interested in English-speaking African countries, or we're only interested in Asia. Or if we leave it as it is, then we get a mixture from all of these 10 countries. We can select specific dates, and here we can search for individual words within the body of the articles. So if I were to type Obama here, then I would obtain all the articles that mention Obama somewhere in the text. And here you have the maximum amount of text that you are to extract. For something like Obama, there are going to be many, many more than we can possibly create a corpus for. So it's going to be limited, and the texts are going to be randomly selected from the Now corpus. For now, I'm going to put Obama over here, and I'm going to say that I'm interested in, say, Asian countries, and I'm going to leave this to 1,000 texts. So here is the selection that the interface has selected for me. These are all articles, as you can see, from various Asian countries: Bangladesh, Hong Kong, India. Here we see the full title of the article, and if I clicked on it, then I would be able to read the article. And at this stage, you can deselect certain articles that you think are not suitable for your virtual corpus. If you're happy with the selection as it is, then you simply save your corpus, you give it a name. So I'm going to call mine Obama and submit. So here my own personalized corpus is saved under the name Obama, and it's only visible for me under my account. I can look for keywords within this specialized corpus: nouns, verbs, adjectives, and so on and so forth. And I can search within my subcorpus, within this particular Obama corpus. To do so, I go back to the search, and it should be visible down here, but as you can see, it's not yet the case. But if I reload, I reckon that it will work. So I've reloaded the page, and let's see, now if I click on Text and Virtual, all is well. Here is my virtual corpus, Obama. Now that I've selected this, when I make a search here, for example, I'm going to search for the lemma vote, and I'm interested in vote as a verb. Then if I click on Find Matching Strings, I will now only be looking for the verb to vote within my Obama corpus. And we see that we have quite a few instances of various forms of vote. I'm going to take a random sample from all of these forms of the verb vote. And here are the concordance lines, so I can find in which context the verb vote is used. And if I clicked on any of these, then I would be able to get the full article in a new tab so that I could read more context. So this first method to create your virtual corpus uses only individual words. So when we clicked here in article title and in the words within the text, we could only have individual words. If we wanted to search for phrases, for example, if I were interested in creating a virtual corpus about sign language, those are two words, I would have to go about this in a slightly different manner. So if I go back to the search, you can see here in the help page that you have the option to create a corpus also by keywords in the text. And so if I click on this, I will find out more information about how to do this. And it tells me that to create a virtual corpus by keywords, I can enter a word or phrase and then set the text virtual panel here to find the text. So I'm going to try this option out with the topic sign language, which I'm interested in. And here I click on find text. Here are a number of articles that have sign language as a key phrase. Lots of them, as you can see, from various countries. I can save the list, and here I can save it as my virtual corpus on sign language. So I now have two virtual corpora that I've created, one on Obama, which I created with the individual word Obama used in the titles of the articles. And here I limited my subcorpus, my virtual corpus rather, to articles from Asia. And here I have a second virtual corpus on sign language. I can refresh the list over here so that I can now see my two virtual corpora. If I'm interested in searching within that corpus, then I can simply select it down here and then search within this corpus. So here I'm interested in the term interpreter. I can see that the term interpreter occurs 127 times within my virtual corpus on sign interpreting. And here I can see in which context it's used in more detail. I can also find the keywords within my virtual corpus. So I've selected it and now I click on find keywords. And I'm interested in the nouns which are specific to articles on sign language. And unsurprisingly, interpreter is one of those, as well as signer, deafness, language sign impairment, to give you some examples. And then I could, again, go within the corpus to find out exactly in which context these particular words are used. So remember, you can create a virtual corpus on EnglishCorpora.org within any of these corpora available. And of use may well be the NOW corpus that I've shown you, but also the Wikipedia corpus, or perhaps some of the TV language corpora, the TBE corpus, the movie corpus, or the corpus of American soap operas. And remember that there are two methods to create a virtual corpus. You can create your virtual corpus with individual words by clicking on Text Virtuals Create Corpus. And you would have lots of different options to choose specific genres in this case, and also keywords within the movie title, in the plot, or in the script itself. But if you wanted to look for phrases, this would not be possible here. Here you need to use single words. So if you're interested in a phrase such as sign language, then you would have to create your subcorpus using the second method I showed you. This would be typing the phrase in here and then finding text. I hope that was useful and that you enjoy creating your first virtual corpus on EnglishCorpora.org. Good luck.